Inside action, and we're just about set to kick off. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Oregon is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. He'll return it from the one. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The Broncos and their ground game's always been sensational. It's not always one guy, Herbie. Sometimes they've got two or three that can carry the load.
And that's what makes it so tough for this defense, is you're not focusing in on just one guy. You're focusing in on really an entire scheme. And because of that diversity, I think it makes it more of a challenge. And you got to be better tacklers in the open field. And I think that's really what they've stressed all week, is tackling and gang tackling and getting to the football.
Hard to get to guys and make tackles in space. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 23. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3. Zips it to the back. They'll knock him down for a loss. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little.
You always like to move the ball at least past midfield, if only to win the field position battle. The defense wasn't going to give them anything on that drive.
Bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one.
You're always looking for the home run return, the big highlight. Didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Quick pass. Tackle at the 49. Up the middle for a nice game. Makes it to the 34.
The play was very well conceived as they were able to get a decent gain and a first down.
There's a strike complete. He's down. Field brought down around the 12-yard line.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. And down he goes, right around the 4-yard line. Going to try and scramble, and he's tackled at the 1.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. It's the third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
And they make the stop at the five.
He knew it was a run all the way. He got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
From the 5-yard line, second down. Tackle made at the 5-yard line. Here's the 11th play of the drive. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Nice run up the middle. A 4-yard gain by the halfback on the option. Can the defense make a stop? Fourth down and goal to go. We're at the 1-yard line.
The Ducks saw one of their key guys go down earlier. It looks like he might be able to get back in the action.
He's scrambling. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. On the extra point.
So a 12 play, 55 yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
So our score,
7-0.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Across the 30. And he shoved out of bounds
around the 33 yard line. Oregon's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you've got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Makes the catch, and look out. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. He's taken down at the 38.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
Release. Oh, had it knocked down.
Wasn't a bad pass at all, but just a good heads-up effort to get his fingertips on the ball.
He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
He takes it right side for a good game.
Quarter of play. We've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. 7-0, Oregon.
And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2. Oregon up 7 points. Gets it out quickly. They'll bring him down at the 39. Good-looking play there.
I think they did a great job up front here, allowing the quarterback enough time to look downfield and spot the open man.
Throws it in a hurry. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
second and 10.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. He's tackled at about the 29-yard line. And he's taken down around the 19-yard line. Carries the ball for a nice game.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Quick strike and he drops it. From the 15-yard line, second down. Oregon is up a score. And he makes it out to about the 14-yard line. Here they come. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Oregon is hoping to make this a two-score game. He gets it up, and he's got it. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 24. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead. And on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Here's a give up the middle, tackled right away. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Slings it. Tackle at the 34-yard line. Fights forwards about the 36. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 36. That's a great tackle at the 48. Strike complete. Brought down right around the 30.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
First and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. Got a receiver and he dropped it.
Number 17, the intended receiver. That makes it pass at second and 10.
Five wide. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 16-yard line.
This is the eighth play of this drive. And he's immediately tackled.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
He's knocked out of bounds at the three. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Hit before he could go anywhere. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. Almost had it, but it's incomplete. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights. Boise State to kick. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 19-yard line.
You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this well.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break? Eventually could be the team that wins it.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Slings it out there incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 19. Oregon is up 7. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's out to the 30. He's to the 40. And down he goes at the 49-yard line.
You know, I think this play works right now, and I wouldn't be surprised at all, Brad, to see this offense maybe go back to this play a little bit later in the game for maybe another big play.
One play, and he'll lose yards. They couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage on that one.
Well, I don't think they did a very good job of selling the pass. The defense was able to read the play and come right in there and make a nice stop.
He lets it go. They can't connect. Incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. It out. There's a very impressive open field tackle. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. Nope, they snap it to the upback. He makes it to the 42-yard line. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. And he can't get away from the pressure. We've still got a half of football remaining. Oregon's lead is a touchdown.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Both of these defenses are opportunistic. They're very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively. How about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herbstreit's first point of analysis would be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. We always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
Number seven, return.
He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 22-yard line. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Oregon is up by a touchdown. Sets up a screen, incomplete.
He was a little erratic on that pass, but there's no denying that he can really hum it in there.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 22. He's in trouble. Quick pass. Good open field tackle. Makes it out to about the 49. The middle for a nice game. From the 46-yard line, it's first down. He'll take it himself. The stop around the 16-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 16-yard line, first down. The Ducks running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game. And now he's got room to run, and he's tackled at the 4. Oregon up 7 points. Tackle made around the 1 yard line. Now he's scrambling. They'll make the sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver,
get out of the pocket, and throw the ball away.
It's the 11th play of the drive. Scrambled out. He can't get away from the pressure. And they get to him again.
You know, the offense might want to make an adjustment and have one of their running backs help out in pass protection. You don't want this young guy getting tentative and making mistakes.
This one should be makeable. Oregon can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. It's up, and the field goal is good. The Ducks quarterback went down with that injury that you saw earlier. We don't want to speculate, but he's in the locker room, and it doesn't look good. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's taken down around the 27-yard line. A bullet out to the right, and he's hit immediately.
You know, they did a great job here of not just getting past the first down marker, but picking up some major yards on the play.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. He's tackled after positive yardage.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That makes it second and 6.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Four down, four down. Hey, look 48. Hey, look 48. Go. Go 49. Take
motion. Motion. This is incomplete. Number 17 was the intended receiver on the play.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. Slings it out, and it gets tipped. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, trying to kick it out of bounds. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. The quarterback leads his squad back out. They got three on their last possession. He has some room. He's tackled at the 29. Receiver, and he can't hang on. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. And they get nice yardage on that run. From their own 36-yard line. Second down.
Check girls, check girls, check girls. Mike 13, Mike 13.
Here we go. Red, six,
and they hit him in the backfield. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that. They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Makes it out to about the 46. From their own 46-yard line. First down. So at the end of three, Oregon leads 13-3. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Play action. He lets it fly. And he's got it. Going the other way now. He didn't throw it away under pressure, and it really cost him.
It sure did. He saw that he was going to get hit and just threw one up for grabs. He's got to learn to take the sack.
From their own 19-yard line, it's first down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. And a quick throw. Excellent open field tackle. He's taken down at the 28-yard line. He's to the 40. And he's taken down at the 45.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
And he hits him hard at the 37. They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Quick pass, intercepted.
Really nice cover skill shown here this time. That's exactly what you want to see from your young corners.
From midfield, first down.
Hey,
the 42-yard line.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Brought down at the 39.
You know, the offense right now just seems to be managing the clock. Another first down. Move the sticks, start the clock again, but offense doesn't seem to be in much of a hurry at this point.
Makes it out to about the 29.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. He's at the 20. Boise State will take a timeout. That's their 2nd of the half.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
And down he goes, right around the 8-yard line.
Well, the offense coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the 5th first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
They go with the run, and they make the stop just outside the goal line. Touchdown, Oregon! Well, with that score, now it's up to the defense, and they're well aware that maybe one stop and they've got a victory. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Oregon gets set to kick this one away. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. And they push him out right around the 26-yard line. The Broncos thought they had the right game plan and the right player to do it. Neither worked out for them.
Yeah, I think the game plan and the star player came into this game with a lot of confidence. What they weren't able to really think about was how good this defense would be that they were facing today. And today they just got completely shut down.
He goes out of bounds around the 33-yard line. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So they review it, but there's just not enough evidence to overturn this one. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on 2nd down. Under a minute left in the game. He wants it all. And that just might do it. Intercepted.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
From their own 31-yard line. First down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. He'll go down to one knee. This one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 20-3, Ducks. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.